The Gutenberg printing press. A perfectly composed block of metallic type would be secured with a cord made of hemp. This would be wound 3 or 4 times around it, a loop made, and this in turn pulled tight with a bodkin. This enabled the block of metallic type to be transferred to the galley of the printing press. There it would be wedged tightly into the cradle of the press. 2 firm leather inking pads would be used to rub printing ink, made from linseed oil and soot, evenly across the entire metallic surface. Next, as shown in this reconstruction of the Gutenberg printing press, dampened sheets of paper would be positioned very carefully within the frame, forming a partial lid for the cradle. By means of a hand crank, positioned below a rectangular pan, the cradle mechanism is closed. With a powerful tug on the so-called press bar, a large screw was made to turn. This action pressed the pan against the lid of the cradle, the sheet of paper held within that lid, and the freshly inked block of metallic type. Finally, the sheet of paper, at this point printed only on one side, was taken out of the printing press and hung up on a line to dry.